for Christmas, we watched the Goosebumps movie over and over and over. And that just goes to show, you know, any time of the year, you're watching Goosebumps. It doesn't necessarily have to be Halloween when they originally released the movie last year. It could be any time of the year. It could be Valentine's Day, for God's sake, and you'll find yourself watching Goosebumps because we are just as big of fans of Goosebumps as we were as kids. And that just goes to show how things don't necessarily just be given up on and how we go back to things that we were fans of. You know, that theme song that I played at the start of the show, you know, that probably brought back a lot of memories for you. I know it's a remixed version of the original Goosebumps theme song, but I mean, how many people thought about the original opening of Goosebumps when I first played that song? I mean, everybody probably did, and everybody remembered, you know, collecting the books and how the TV show was based off the original books, how all the characters that were written about were played by different actors and actresses, and how they did their greatest jobs of bringing these characters to life. I mean, everybody remembers that. And R.L. Stine and Jane Stine can produce all these TV shows they want, like The Haunting Hour, here in 2016, but it's never going to be as good as what the Goosebumps TV series was, which definitely the Stines prided themselves off of for years. And you can imagine why, because the characters were so creative, and I think that's really what made Goosebumps stand out to the past generation, and what's still making it stand out and be relevant here to this new generation, who we have more fans of, seemingly, than we ever have before. And this is the thing about the TV series Goosebumps. They are showing the original Goosebumps TV series. They are showing the original transcripts from the original 90s. It's not like they've revamped the entire series. So why not try revamping the entire series? Well, obviously the answer to that is because the TV series, the original releases, are popular, and you're never going to be able to redistribute the original Goosebumps series in a way that people are going to accept it from the 90s, and even this new generation are going to accept it because they are fans of what was original, and definitely original is what kills here in 2016. Because I think that, you know, I'll never give up on the original 90s TV shows that I used to watch, like Goosebumps. Not just Goosebumps, but shows like Are You Afraid of the Dark, Eerie Indiana, which is another one that a lot of people probably have forgotten about. Remember Eerie Indiana and how a family of probably four or five individuals lived in Indiana, and all this eerie stuff used to happen. That used to air after Goosebumps on Saturdays on Fox Kids, for those of you that don't remember. I remember that one. I remember Freaky Stories. I remember Are You Afraid of the Dark, like I just mentioned, all 100 of that episodes. There were so much things. The Twilight Zone, I remember all that from the 90s, and I'm still as big of a fan of all of these TV shows as I was back in the 90s that I remember that I wish were still relevant and still around like Goosebumps is now. But I definitely have to thank Teletoon for still showing Goosebumps, because I think that without them still showing Goosebumps, I don't think it would be as popular as what it is now. And, you know, in response to people that were saying, you know, it's too late in 2015 and 2016 to be bringing back something like Goosebumps, I don't think it is. It may be looked at in the way of being brought back too late in the minds of a lot of people, because it probably should have been brought back in the early thousands. I know that was something that I had said on my show, is it probably should have been brought back in the early thousands until it's only being brought back now. But the thing is, I think that it's never too late for something like this, and I think that we are always, once a fan of something like Goosebumps, you're always going to be a fan of something like Goosebumps, and you're not going to forget about it. I know that it's going to be a long time before I forget about these original characters and the original transcripts, and you can do as much as you want with a series like this. And do I think there could be a sequel of Goosebumps? There is a chance that it is a one-hit wonder, but there still is just as much of a chance of it still being brought back as a sequel. You know, a second or a third Goosebumps movie, there is room for that, because we know what happened, of course, at the end of the original Goosebumps movie last year, and that definitely brings about a question of will we see a second or a third movie released. I think there is a chance for that, especially with how many Goosebumps fans we have. Remember how they had the TV series Goosebumps, and they had Ultimate Goosebumps when they tried to change it and just make it more scarier and make it stand out more by changing the opening, you know, remixing the theme like they did, and they had the guest appearances of Chris Leary on Fox Kids Countdown every Saturday morning of the Goosebumps characters like Slappy. I know they had the voice of the Slappy dummy as a guest on the Fox Kids Countdown sometimes, on and off again, promoting something going on with the Goosebumps. I think they did a great job with that. They did everything to promote it, and that's why it's still relevant here in 2016 and will continue to be for a really long time. Definitely this will bring back a lot of memories for everybody. I know I talked about the movie last year when it was first released in the fall of 2015. They released it on Halloween, and they specifically did that And it definitely brought back a lot of memories for me, and I just thought I would drop another video blog to kind of update you on how I feel about how the TV series is still relevant and how they're showing the original TV series, which I give them a lot of credit for doing, because they could be trying to recreate the original TV series, which I think doesn't need to be being done. I think that originality is something you shouldn't stray away from, and I think this is something that cannot be recreated, because once created, there's no way you can go back on trying to recreate something like Goosebumps, because Goosebumps is something that will never be forgotten, especially by the older generations of Goosebumps fan that go back through the generations. I remember all the original episodes of Goosebumps, like the Shocker on Shock Street, the Abominable Snowman, the Haunted Mask, the Barking Ghost. They were all a part of the series. They had four seasons of Goosebumps. By season four, they had ran out of books to write series episodes on, and they started putting out, you know, two-part series like How I Got My Shrunken Head, Deep Trouble was another one. There were so many of these, The Ghost Next Door, but they had ran out by season four, and by season four, they had put out over 75 episodes of Goosebumps, and by seasons 1 through 3, they have put out all the popular books that they have based the series off of. But I think that there's something about this Goosebumps thing that is refusing to go away, and I really appreciate what they've done with this, and I'm sure everybody else has a greater appreciation for Goosebumps, especially my nephew, who is the biggest Goosebumps fan in the world. But if you have a comment and a memory, you can tell me what your favorite Goosebumps episode was. You can tell me what your favorite Goosebumps character was. You can leave it for it in the comments of this video at JonathanClark22. You can tweet me on Twitter at JonathanClark1. And you can let me know what's up on my Facebook page and Google+ at HGW Entertainment and get in on the conversation about Goosebumps, which still seems to be as popular as it ever was and still is relevant here in 2016. And without a doubt, that's the coolest thing about this Goosebumps conversation, is that it's still as popular as it ever was. It's reintroduced now to a new generation of Goosebumps fans who are definitely probably going to carry it on to the next generation and the generation after that. I think that would be really cool, and they really need to think about, you know, recreating this Goosebumps series to this new generation. I don't think I would be as big of a fan of the recreation and redistribution of the original series, because once created, you can't go back on that. But they definitely need to think about doing more with Goosebumps than what they're doing now, because we have just as many fans of the series as what we had back in the 90s. And if you want to get in on the conversation, if you have a thought on Goosebumps, you can join the conversation on my Facebook page at HGW Entertainment, on Twitter at JonathanClark1, and on my YouTube channel at JonathanClark22, as I look forward to hearing about your favorite memories from the TV series or the books, which definitely is what I go back to. Collecting the Goosebumps books is something that I can never get enough of, couldn't get enough of, and still can't get enough of. These new editions, these collector's editions of the Goosebumps books are really, really awesome. So I'm going to throw this video up on my YouTube channel. You can get on the conversation with this if you wish, and let me know what you think of Goosebumps still being as popular, even more popular than it ever was from the 90s, being brought back in 2015, 2016, and generations to come that we haven't even been a part of yet or experienced. It's so fun still talking about Goosebumps, which I can give a lot of credit to a lot of people for being the reasons behind everything that's happened. I said, you know, Goosebumps being brought back here in 2014, 2015 would have been cool, and it's still as cool as it ever was, and it's something that I don't think any of us are going to forget about anytime soon. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will talk to you again next week.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. All the girls on the block knocking at my door. Wanna know what it is, make the boys want more. Is your lover playing on your side? Said he loves you, but he ain't got time. Here's the answer, come and get it, and a knockdown prize. I'll make you fall in love.